What is the research on inflammation and low carbohydrate interventions? I mean, speaking to our trial and the data that we have now, if you look at the hsCRP data, we're seeing significant improvements in CRP from baseline to 1 year in this group of people. And I think that in the study you mentioned with Jeff and I think it was Cassandra Forsyth's paper, significant improvements in CRP, and then I think you did pro-inflammatory cytokines too, right? That one had TNF-alpha and IL-6, and I think at the end of those 12 weeks you also had improvements.
Yeah, that study was in people with metabolic syndrome for 12 weeks duration. And let me just say that, you know, different researchers have their pet biomarkers. So somebody wants, you know, IL-6, somebody else likes, I mean, this sounds like alphabet soup here, IL-1 beta or TNF-alpha or IGF-1, PI-1. I mean, these are all, so rather than pick somebody's favorite and upset somebody else because we didn't pick their favorite, we studied 14 biomarkers. Mm-hmm. In these people after 12 weeks. After 12 weeks, for all 14, none of them had a superior response, that is a greater lowering in the high carbohydrate, low fat group. Mm-hmm. So none of them were better off compared to the low carb ketogenic group. The low carb ketogenic group, 7 out of the 14 were not just lower, but significantly lower. Sure. So which And both of them were weight loss studies. They're both groups lost weight. Yep. But the ketogenic diet markedly and consistently downregulated a number of biomarkers. And by the way, those are also bioactive compounds. They're also doing things. So we were changing inflammation at a number of different cellular sites within the body in a coordinated way. And we think that's much better than targeting one single biomarker and making that go down, is what which is typically done with drugs that are targeted for anti-inflammatory effects.
Sure.